Okay, so welcome to the session. I just started recording, so we are online, not really online, but we are recording the session. So welcome to the FabLabka's guest talk on this, more like a discussion on how to use digitalize or how to use digital technology to improve and enhance SMEs in Sri Lanka. So we have two guest speakers and two discussions or more facilitators of the session. We have also people joining from different parts of the world. So very quickly, what now, for example, how we are planning to do is, now I'll hand over after my introduction or welcome to Priyanka, who will be introducing the speakers and also the topic. And then two speakers, Priyankara and Kithsiri, will be giving you the main ideas, and then we will have a discussion on the topic. Again, as other days, we will have multiple logins. So when this is disconnected after 40 minutes, you can come back to the same URL, and then we will have a discussion. We have very senior people, experts of the subject, including Professor Patirana. So thank you very much again for joining. May I hand over to Priyanka, or maybe we can very quickly discuss, say hi to each other, starting from Professor Patirana. Unmute the mic and speak.
Hello, everybody. Anyway, I hope you don't need an instruction. Every time I used to do the same instruction. Completed my degree in 1978, and since then I've been with University of Peradeniya. Okay, good. Good to see you all.
Yeah. Okay. And Gayan, Srinath.
Hi everyone. I'm working for Brandix. So I have been a founding member for FabLab. So I'm also want to learn, and so having the discussion about how 3D printing can help the SMEs today. So I'm excited to learn the discussion is going on.
Okay, thank you very
nice
much.
Nice to see you all.
Yeah, thank you very much. Then Roshan.
Hello, this is Roshan Lianage from Seattle, Washington. I work for a biopharmaceutical company in the United States called Bristol Myers Squibb. I got my PhD in bioanalytical chemistry, and now I work in the field of bioprocess development and manufacturing supply at BMS. So I am interested in like 3D printing technologies, you know, where we can apply this into biopharmaceutical development, especially in the area where we can use this for bioprocess analytics and also for toxicology study that that can be used with tissues that are, you know, 3D printed and things like that. So I'm interested in this forum for that reason. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Roshan. Thank you. Nice to see you back.
Yep.
Yeah, Buddhika, Jayasena.
Hello, everyone. I'm joining from Atlanta, Georgia. I took graduated from Peradeniya, and then I completed my PhD in Singapore and came back to USA. Now, currently, I'm working in the biomedical device industry. So it's glad to be in this session. So, all right, that's all.
Okay, thank you very much. Prabhudu?
Hello, everyone. I am Prabhudu Senaratna, joining from Colombo, Sri Lanka. And my background is psychology. I am a lecturer. I graduated from University of Peradeniya, and I then did my master's from University of Delhi, India. I'm actually right now, I'm a co-founder of FabLabka Foundation. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Divanka, just join. Hello. Say hi to the audience. Divanka, if you hear me.
Hi, can you guys hear me?
Yeah, we hear you. Yeah, good.
Okay. Hi, my name is Divanka. I am joining from Seattle. I work as a systems engineer at Boeing.
Okay, thank you very much. Gresham, quickly. Oh, Okay, great. Fine.
Yeah. Good to see everyone. I'm also joining from Seattle, Washington, and I also work for Boeing company. And I think everyone in this meeting knows me well, so I don't want to spend more time. I'm looking forward to the talk, and it's going to be a very, I hope it's going to be a very important topic for us.
Right, okay, thank you very much. Now, you should remember, all of you, now we introduce each other because this will be recorded, so it will be in YouTube later. Now it's been recorded, so we want other people also, people who are watching, to know about you. That's the idea. So thank you very much anyway, so you don't get bored introducing yourself again and again. Okay, so I couldn't introduce myself. I'm Chaminda Hettiarachchi. I'm connected from Sri Lanka, from Colombo. I'm hosting this event, and I'm so like only like a logistic provider. I'm also co-founder and director at FabLabka. Now we have, we keep the speakers to be formally introduced, and now I'll introduce Priyanka to you. Priyanka, not introduce, but hand over to Priyanka. But anybody missing from the introduction? No, everybody introduced. Yes. Okay, Priyanka.
Yeah, of course.
How about you?
Yeah. I think everybody knows me, and I no need to introduce myself. I'm Priyanka, founding member of FabLabka Foundation. So good evening, everybody from Sri Lanka once again, and welcome to the FabLabka monthly test talk. Today we are going to hear and discuss on technology transfer to SMEs. And our vision, FabLabka's vision, to transform Sri Lanka into a manufacturing-based economy. There we consider SME sector is as one of FabLabka's targeted key beneficiaries. So because we consider the SME sector to be the real backbone of Sri Lanka economy, we consider they'll be one of our key beneficiaries. So I hope that we could address issues, you know, things like the current SME sector in Sri Lanka face, like access to finance, access to technology, access to markets. So we see there is a widespread lack of business development services for the SME sector. So this is, of course, one of the key areas that we at FabLabka are going to address.
Priyanka, do you mind a little bit lowering your camera, because we see only the top part of your head.
It's better now?
Yes.
And also at FabLabka, we believe that, you know, with the latest technology, you know, like 3D printing, artificial intelligence, the Internet of Things and all that, that the strategy of the SME sector should completely change. I mean, they only have to be innovative, you know, rather than trying to, you know, become big by heavy investments and all that. And we always, you know, talk of, you know, the economies of scale getting outdated, and, you know, economies of scope getting enhanced and all that. So I believe we can discuss all this today. And so to enlighten us on more about SMEs and how they should be transforming with digital technology, we have today two of the industry experts as our speakers, Engineer Kithsiri K. Wijesundera and Engineer Priyankara Rathnamalala. So let me just briefly introduce the two guest speakers, their profiles. Engineer Priyankara is the Director General of Industrial Development Board of Sri Lanka. He has gained exposure and experience in diversified disciplines in private as well as in the public sector, both locally and internationally. Ceylon Glass Company, John Keyes Holdings, and Regnings Sri Lanka Limited. At these places, he has held different engineering positions. He at present is the chief officer in charge of many technology development, business management, and skill development programs being carried out island-wide for development of local industry under the purview of Ministry and Industry of Commerce. For example, the Center of Excellence for Robotic Applications, which has been established as a private-public partnership company, is a primary initiative taken for the advancement of local industry base. He has also been a lecturer in business ethics and corporate governance, leadership development and operations management for bachelor's degrees and MBA programs at ICFAI University and IIHE University in Sri Lanka. And his background, he's a chartered engineer by profession and holds a degree in production engineering from University of Peradeniya. He also has obtained a postgraduate diploma in business and financial administration from the Institute of Chartered Accountants, Sri Lanka, and a master in business administration, specializing in finance from International University of Japan. And the next speaker, the co-speaker is engineer Kithsiri K. Wijesundera, the principal consultant of KiWi Strategy Consultants. He is widely experienced in the field of engineering, marketing, and in leading manufacturing organizations. He's also an experienced lecturer. Just to give some of the areas, some of the places he has worked, he has been the former chief marketing officer at Hutchison Telecommunications, former director of operations at Sierra Inu, former chief executive officer at Dunkirk Rosaline, and also as a lecturer, module leader at, on project management at IIHE, the Imperial Institute of Higher Education. He's a chartered engineer by profession and holds a degree in mechanical engineering from University of Peradeniya. So over to you, Kithsiri and Priyankara, to just to speak on the topic.
Now we can't hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
I had muted the microphone to minimize disturbance to you all. Okay. Anyway, I have a little technical problem in getting the screen back where I can see all of you. But I'll get my presentation on and I can start on it. In the meantime, is it possible for you to play that 1 minute video about 3D printing to SMEs?
I'll try. You can keep on talking.
Right. I can do it. If you can see my screen, I can do that.
Yeah. We can see. Yeah. We can see your technology transfer. Yes.
Okay.
Okay, I'm playing the video now.
Chaminda, we don't see your screen, so I think Kithsiri should play
the screen.
Oh, otherwise you have to share.
Chaminda, we don't see the video.
Can you hear the audio?
Yeah, we hear the audio, but Chaminda has not shared. I think Kithsiri should do that.
Hey, I'll try again. Kithsiri, can you do it?
Hello, I'm Uday Dharwa, manufacturer in Afrotech to present 3D printing. 3D printing is a process of printing.
No, we can't see the video.
Okay, just a minute.
So, will you be able to see it, or if not, I will carry on with my presentation, and we'll see it probably later when we sort out the.
Actually, what we can do is I'll share URL. You can go to the talk.
Okay, fine. I have got my presentation on, so that is good. Okay. Really, the topic you have given is interesting. It's good for marketing. But when you look at the issue in front of us, this is why I want to show you that video. We were looking at the 3D printing technology, how to take it to the Sri Lankan SME companies. So in that, what I thought was, I brought in Priyanka Rathnamalala, who is actually my cousin brother, and who is the Director General of Industrial Development Board, who has actually not only experience, but also the responsibility to bring in new technologies to the SME sector. So he has many ideas. We have had discussions in the past about what can be done about Sri Lankan SMEs. And anyway, in this presentation, therefore, I thought I will talk about some of the theories or some of the research findings about transfer of technology to SMEs in general. And thereafter, we would be able to check, we will be able to talk about what the real issues in Sri Lanka and how we can find a way of linking with the SMEs for FabLabka. So with that, I will quickly run through this, and I do not intend really lecturing on this, but just to get the correct perspectives, I will highlight some of the aspects. Now, when we talk about technology transfer, it's a process of sharing of skills, knowledge, technologies, and methods to develop and exploit the technology into new products, processes, applications, materials, or services. So this is exactly what we are looking at. We have got a facility where we can demonstrate 3D printing, and probably we can train some people, but then that is only one aspect of technology transfer. Probably that's where the knowledge and skills can be given. But we are looking at more, where some of the local industrialists be able to either invest on their own or as joint ventures or whichever the form, and get the processes, applications, and even materials and services. So that's the major component of technology transfer. So once again, technology transfer is considered a knowledge transfer. So that is where probably why we are interested in it. We need to bring in not only this technology. When you look at the topic that circulated by Chaminda, we are talking about digital technologies. Digital technologies are many. So that itself is a huge subject if you want to talk about. Probably we can talk about in different components. And we'll try to keep to probably 3D printing for this discussion. Then transfer here does not mean movement or delivery. Transfer can only happen if technology has already been used. So really speaking, only when the SMEs have begun to use 3D printing for their day-to-day production purposes or commercial purposes, then only we can say the transfer has happened. Next, we look at the technology transfer process. This has many steps, and this is again a common description, which is not only for SMEs, but even for other companies. But I will quickly run through it. First, the identification of the technology need. Now, this is something maybe the SMEs may not be able to do by themselves. So that is where probably we'll have to work with them. We'll have to understand their setups, and then we can see how we can bring in 3D printing into it. So in other words, we need to define the exact requirements of the technology. And then we need to probably identify the nature and components of it, technology with or without continual support, etc. Then also we have to look at sources of technology. I know 3D printing could be got from many sources, and apparently when I was searching for some YouTube videos, I saw Korea has developed some cheaper technology now, and I'm sure the cost of technology will be very much less. So with that, many sources will be available. And if you are going in for the highest end of 3D printing, there is now there is even machines which are capable of producing hundreds of parts within very short times. And as a result of that, cost per metal part, I thought a pump impeller kind of thing that is being made in metal has come down to $4.50. So this is a very challenging, now that is where really the 3D printing can challenge traditional production, and even casting can be replaced with this, with better quality products. But then is that affordable? I mean, we are not definitely talking about bringing that kind of technology to our SMEs in the near future. It should happen, and probably if it happens before our lives end, I think we'll be happy. Then the technology evaluation. The technology has to be evaluated based on many factors. I will not go into all the details of it, but then mainly we have to find a match between the current capabilities and what can be achieved in the shorter term. Likewise, we may have to phase out program where the technology can, do a proper transfer, that evaluation is important. Having identified the technology and having identified what you want, then of course there are negotiations. These are mostly commercial and legal negotiations. How to do the technology transfer? Is it going to be a joint venture, or is it going to be FDI, or is it going to be merely a purchase agreement or whatever? Then finally, the agreement has to be reached. So this is the technology process, the five major steps in that. Then who are the stakeholders in technology transfer? That again is important. There are innovators, developers, owners, suppliers. Of course, we may cut innovators, developers, and owners, and straight away we know where to buy the 3D printing presses. So therefore, we may start with suppliers. Then there are buyers, recipients, users, consumers, financiers, donors, governments, policymakers, regulators, insurers, international institutions, NGOs like us, and community-based organizations. So all that, all those people are becoming stakeholders of technology transfer. So we need to identify who are the key stakeholders for the transfer we are going to do, and then we should have a way of getting the cooperation of all those stakeholders. The stakeholders involved in any specific transaction will depend on the type and status of the technology and the associated nature of the transfer pathway. Then we go into expected deliverables. Now, when the technology transfer is done, this is what should be there. Whoever has received the technology should have the right to use the technology in order to make products, solutions in a specified location for a specified time frame as defined in technology transfer agreement signed by the concerned parties. Then we have to get the licensing of the patent or intellectual property in order to suffice the legal aspect mentioned in the register of patents or the relevant sections in the agreement. I know our team consists of legal experts too, so they could elaborate on that subject. Then the documentation, all relevant and necessary documents required for the successful functioning and maintenance of the technology, such as engineering drawings, user manuals, process charts, etc. In fact, this actually, I need a little bit of digressing here because the technology transfer was knowledge transfer, that's what we said. But in knowledge, you have the facts as well as the tacit knowledge. Probably the transfer of the facts is what is happening through documentation. And whatever the procedures that are there, and these engineering drawings, user manuals, process charts will convey that. But it's the tacit knowledge which is more difficult to transfer. But that is what is important to somebody who is trying to use the technology in a commercial way. So maybe that's an area we should really investigate and probably work out a strategy how to get that tacit knowledge. Maybe some of our colleagues have that tacit knowledge, having worked with 3D printing for some time. But for us, we are people who have mainly read about it, seen YouTube videos. I still haven't seen the machine in Makandura maybe. But having really worked with it only, the tacit knowledge could be great. So that's another important aspect. And I would consider that is also part of the expected deliverables. Then after sales support, including providing trained personnel on site for setting up technology and fixing technical problems and demonstrations, etc., is really the after sales support that is expected from technology suppliers.
Okay, sorry. Now we have 2 minutes left in this session. When you reconnect, when you disconnected, please come back with the click the same URL. You can continue.
Yes,
we can wait for the next.
about what I said about the knowledge, if you can see my screen now, you will pyramid with the explicit knowledge on top, which is easier to transfer, codified knowledge found in documents, databases, etc. It's essential for transfer and storage, but it's the tacit one, intuitive knowledge and know-how, which is rooted in context, experience, practice, and values. This is the harder part to communicate. It resides in the mind of the practitioner, and the best source of long-term competitive advantage and innovation depends on it. So generally, it has to be transferred through socialization, mentoring, etc. IT is mainly as support. I think with this, I will finish my presentation, and probably when we connect again, Priyanka could start on his presentation.
Excellent. Very good timing. We have 1 minute more.
Well, if there's anything you want to quickly discuss, I am open.
Yeah. Hi, Kithsiri. This is Gresham. So yeah, this is a very important point, this tacit knowledge. In fact, I have a suggestion to make here, because the tacit knowledge about the additive manufacturing is, again, very spotty. When I say additive manufacturing, which is, that is 3D printing. Currently I am working with some international standard organizations about standardization of the processes. And then we find that it is very hard to have a common set of documentation process yet, because those have been developed now. So because it's the technology is out there, because this was emerged with mainly with hobbyists, and now it is gaining